Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll understand the concept of time division duplexing and frequency division duplexing. Duplexing is required for simultaneous communication where a person can receive and transmit at the same time. First, we'll see what is the meaning of FDD. FDD stands for Frequency Division Duplexing. Since mobile communication is considered as a duplex communication system in which a person can transmit and receive at the same time, frequency division duplexing is required. Here, every person is allotted a channel, and these channels are divided as forward channel and reverse channel. Because the channels are divided as forward channel and reverse channel, we require a duplexer. Duplexer is a circuit that is provided after antenna. Every mobile station and base station has antennas. After antennas, we require a duplexer because single antenna is required for transmission and reception. Duplexer separates the frequency of both transmission and reception. In FDD, that is frequency division duplexing, it is taken care that the transmission frequency and the receiving frequency should be distance apart, meaning there should be some frequency band which is kept, which is not required by these users but is used by some other users. For example, as shown in the slide here, the frequency division duplexing has two channels, forward channel and reverse channel. And we can see that there is a gap between these frequencies. This is not wasted but used by some other users. The disadvantage of using frequency division duplexing is we require costly duplexer circuits which increase the cost of our system. Our mobile phones also become costly. And in frequency division duplexing, every channel that is provided to the user, if not used, is waste. Hence, we require some other methods to which we can improve the spectrum efficiency. Next, we move on to time division duplexing. In time division duplexing, instead of frequency, as in frequency division duplexing, time is divided amongst the user. Here, we have forward time slot and reverse time slot. Again, we can see in the slide, the forward time slot and the reverse time slot has some gap between them. That is required because otherwise, if the same gap or nearby gaps are used, then the user is receiving and transmitting almost at the same time, which is a bit tedious. Time division duplexing, one can transmit and receive information in different time slots. Here, forward channel is one time slot and reverse channel is another time slot. The advantage of using time division duplexing is we do not require costly duplexer circuits which were used in FDD or frequency division duplexing. Hence, the system is much simpler and the cost is also way less. In time division duplexing, the biggest advantage is even though the time slots are different, we are using single frequency, which makes this system very spectrum efficient. Single frequency used for transmission and reception, but the time slots that are used are different. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.